Hello everyone, and welcome back to experience another of the horrors of XBLIG with me. This time we're playing After Dusk. It's a game that was released in 2011, and it's a bit different from the other horrors we've been seeing. Because those other horrors, they had photorealistic graphics, you might say. Because they were using photographs. After Dusk actually uses sprite graphics, and has something that you might recognize as resembling gameplay. We move left and right, we jump, we shoot. It's really much more of a traditional game than the previous horrors we've been seeing. Let's start a new game. See what it's all about. And I press new game, and it just kind of takes a while. Okay, there we go. After Dusk likes to take its time. It takes place in the far-off future, where a research station has sent out a distress signal. Guess what we're gonna do? That's us. That's the one vessel is us. We're responding to this mission. We're going to accept it. It's a reconnaissance mission. Our job is to go in, see what's going on, report back. We're also thinking about getting some salvage, picking it up, selling it for some profit. Maybe that'll make this mission worth our while. Now we can select the name of our captain. Default name is Jacob, but I don't know if I really feel confident in following Jacob in the battle. Rather, I think that if we're going to be fighting the unknown, and what is scarier than the unknown, honestly, I think there's only one name that we can give our captain that would inspire the courage needed from the crew to face whatever is waiting for us on this station. Someone who is willing to just run in, charge right into this station, and potentially destroy anything we find. Someone who wears, say, face paint that might instill fear in the terrors we might find on Century Station. I think this is a fine name for a captain, and I would follow Captain Ultimate Warrior to the ends of the universe. That's our captain. Okay, the Ultimate Warrior has arrived at Century Station. He's inside. Our crewmate on our ship is Claire. She's our only crewmate. Two-person ship. There's no life support, powers. So, the Ultimate Warrior. Well, I was about to say he must be wearing a spacesuit, but you don't know with the Ultimate Warrior. He might just be wearing what he used to wear to the ring. Using his willpower not to die. Anyway, this is how we play the game. We jump, we move, we shoot. We have this light. We can look around because everything's very dark. As we shoot, we'll use up power, which is in the upper left. And as we use up power, our light becomes dimmer. And the only light that we get are from light sources, like the flashlight and lights, like that overhead light right there. It's not giving out any light right now, though. Claire did mention something about a generator, so we should probably go find it. We can find nuts and bolts, which we'll be able to use for something a little later on. Okay, the generator's turned on, and now the lights are on. That's going to be one of the main things we do throughout After Dusk, is find these generators to turn them on, because someone turned them all off. Well, rather, I guess I should say the main power was turned off. And these backup generators were never turned on. Maybe there was no one there to turn them on. Ah, a computer terminal. If I know anything about survival horror games, there will be notes and diaries, and since it's a future game, they'll be on computers. But why is no one on the station? Maybe we should be concerned about that. The Ultimate Warrior wants to keep an eye out for any life signs. He's a bit cautious, even though Claire seems to be quite happy about there not being anyone here. You can see that we're in the mess hall. All these rooms have different names, which is nice because they all kind of look the same, don't they? What's that? A platform? That fades in and out. Am I imagining this? Is the Ultimate Warrior going mad? How can such a thing be? Let's jump on it. Use that to get up here. Whoop. And those platforms do the same. I might say that this is here as a tutorial to see that there are platforms that can do this. However, you don't see this happen too often in the game, so I'm not entirely sure why it's there. We have not encountered anything yet. And also no reason for the distress signal, and no explanation for why there's no one on board. But we're in the lab, and only good things could happen here. The Ultimate Warrior is the master of the obvious, of course. Well, yes, it doesn't look like anything is happening right now. There's no power, it's dark, there's no life support, no noise, no sounds of any activity on board Sentry Station, so what's happened? And now this is the bridge. You can probably tell that this is where you control the ship from. Looks like it, right? Okay, the main terminal will give us all the answers. What we do know is that spell check did not happen here. Spell check has been disabled on Sentry Station. Not the candles, the most essential of all items on a starship, or space station in this case. How could they not bring enough candles? It looks like Captain Beck's last log was interrupted. The Ultimate Warrior speaking words of wisdom as he usually does. Claire, however, feels that we should explore things perhaps a bit more. Because, I mean, it's such a great find. I mean, she's not the one on board the station, honestly, though. Claire has detected life signs, but it doesn't seem like anyone's on board. Ultimate Warrior can't wait to escape. This is a save point. I'm not going to demonstrate it right now because for some reason it takes like 30 seconds for it to work. I don't know why there seems like there's a lot of load times in this game. You wouldn't think there would be, looking at it. Oh my. There are some parts of the walls that seem dilapidated and we can shoot them. Oh. Good God. What has science wrought? The green men. As you can probably guess, they're zombies. It is XBLIG after all. We can turn this generator on, and they died in the light. Like Captain Beck's log said, they don't like the light. The Ultimate Warrior getting out of this a smart way. We will take the zombies' money, though. We're not above that. Ultimate Warrior putting two and two together, these zombies killed the crew of the space station. Ultimate Warrior does not like zombies. Claire saying that we should probably get out of here. And just as they decided to leave, the computers went berserk. Apparently what we were in was an escape pod, because now it's getting sent out of the space station and down to the planet. But if anyone can escape a hostile alien world, surely it is the Ultimate Warrior. Contact with Claire has been cut off. The Ultimate Warrior is on his own. So our first priority, is to find some means of communication with Claire, as well as survival from the zombies, who are on the planet as well, if you were wondering. So the Ultimate Warrior, all by himself, has to find a way off this world, some way to contact our ship. Things have just gotten very complicated. We were just supposed to go on that space station and go back. But things have just gone all wrong. All of the life on this red planet is hostile to us. It's one of those kinds of planets. Everything wants to kill us. As you can see, we can kill the zombies with our gun. More convenient if we have a lot of light to do the job for us. Can't quite reach that energy pod. You can see my energy is starting to go down now that I'm using the gun. That generator turned on. I think that the music being the funeral march is a bit, premature. The Ultimate Warrior is not dead yet. However, the Warrior cannot make this jump up here. Even though there's a nut and bolt up there implying we can get up there, we cannot make the jump. Well, I just have to go through this door and see what the future brings. Loading. Okay. So there are some man-made structures on the red planet. We're in the sewer system right now. Alright. Got some of my energy back. So we have health to maintain. We also have energy. We only have the one weapon for right now. And we have nuts and we have credits as our currencies. Neither of which we can actually use right now, because we're nowhere near civilization. Let's turn that generator on. Could destroy these walls. But then we have that wall above me, and I can't shoot up, unfortunately. I would really like to know why there's so much load time between rooms and the save points. I honestly don't understand why that happens. Anyway. So, I mean, we're not moving quickly. Oh, we have some doors, but let's just go through this hallway and see what's at the end. We're not moving very quickly. Our gun does not shoot rapid fire. So we're not exactly a powerhouse here. We need to have some distance between us and the zombies, that's health, to actually kill them before they get us. We can take a few hits. At the end of the hallway was a generator. So now that we've done that, let's go back and explore those doors that we passed on the way. Are you scared yet, by the way? Do you think After Dusk has had a good atmosphere? Has it generated a good mood yet? Has it gotten you in the mood for terror? Sometimes we'll encounter locked doors, and we need to find an accompanying terminal that we can use to unlock it. No keys, I don't believe. Rather, everything gets unlocked by a computer. Like I said, I know this game doesn't have the photorealistic, hyper-realistic even, graphics of the previous horrors, so I don't expect it to scare you as much as those games did. Okay, we turned the lights on. However, that was not a computer terminal, so that one locked door is not going to be open from that. However, I do believe we did... Yep, got that. We did pass another door. Let's head back to that. You have to wonder what Claire's doing right now. Frantically trying to contact the Ultimate Warrior, I would assume. A weak wall, but it's above us, and like I said, we can't shoot that. So we'll turn the generator on, which turns on all the lights. Still can't shoot this thing, but it vanished after the enemies died from exposure to light. So there are some weak walls that we cannot actually shoot, but rather... Can't jump that high to get those things, but rather will be destroyed once all the enemies in the room are dead. In any case, the Ultimate Warrior had better hope that he encounters some friendly faces soon. You can't really tell right now, but we're back in the room that we already were in, and this is the terminal that will unlock that one door that we found locked. So you might have noticed that the tile sets did change from when we were on the space station. There's still not a whole lot of variety, but there are different tiles, even if the walls and ceilings are just the one tile. And a different background. The warrior is cautious. A new voice, Clyde. I don't know how we know his name. There's no time to daddle. The warrior does not daddle. The warrior takes decisive action, and we better take decisive action now, because there's something chasing us. That can kill us very fast. Even the warrior with his limitless power would have trouble facing that thing. It's almost on us. Almost. We escaped it. And now I just killed it right now. I don't know if I'm supposed to be able to do that. Or if I could have done that when it was chasing me, because it does kill you very fast if it catches up to you. But yeah, it's dead. So okay. It's gone. Yeah, the Ultimate Warrior thinks so, because he killed it. He's pretty sure it's gone now. No, it wasn't the lights, it was our gun. We shot it. Amazing how simple methods such as shooting a gun can kill something. It makes you think, really. Anyway, Clyde seems to be our friend. Since Clyde has already been here, maybe we can ask him what he knows about what's happening in this situation? He has to know more than us, since we don't know anything. So Clyde has had no power for days. Well, no one else did survive, Clyde. We're new. We didn't come from the station originally. We just came in response to that distress signal. The Ultimate Warrior doesn't think Clyde is all about fighting monsters. Well, a distress signal was reported, but it was not said that there were any details about what was happening. Certainly nothing about zombies or weird slug dragons. Let's not forget our mission. We do need to communicate with Claire, because if we can find that, we will be able to get off the planet. Yep, we have a spaceship. It's the way we came on. Clyde says he can help us on our way. But he's going to defer to us when it comes to the shoot-bang stuff. So Clyde will be our navigator for right now. But he'll stay here until we're ready to leave. So, like, as I asked before, are you frightened? It's a little scary, all the darkness and the zombies. There's actual lose states to this game, you know? We could be killed by zombies. I believe it's the first horror we've played that has involved actually being able to die. There are, like, vending machines in the back. We could use this to replenish ammo if we had any other weapons that used ammo, but we don't. This one, we can upgrade our EV suit using these nuts and bolts that we've been collecting. So I guess we just pour those into the machine, and it fixes up our suit. It's not a bad deal, considering that's just junk. We could replenish our health if we needed to, but we don't. And we can get this, which is a shotgun. We can get this, which increases our jump height. Makes things more accessible to us now. Let's see. Oh, we increased our health bar. So things seem like they're going all right for us. Let's head back to the surface. We got what we needed. We met a new friend. We got some upgrades. So, as for right now, it seems like we're done here. If you didn't kill the dragon, it wouldn't be here. It would just be gone. Again, I'm not sure if you're supposed to be able to kill it. Because the way they were talking, it kind of sounded like we weren't. But we did. Now, the shotgun is much stronger than our normal weapon. But it has limited ammo. And if we find those vending machines like we found in Clyde's lab, we can replenish that ammo for credits. So that's what we would use for that. We can't make that jump over there, so let's head out. Let's see. Okay. Actually, can I? No, I can't do that. Let's just go down here. If we go down here, this should take us back. Oh, yeah, to here. We had to wait for these guys to die before that ceiling vanished. Still can't shoot upwards, it seems, with the shotgun, even though it has a bit of a spread shot. Doesn't really seem like I can. I could try to make that jump, but it doesn't look like I can make it. I can reach some of this stuff now. So like I said, it's not a very fast-paced game. It kind of takes its time with what it's doing. We could just jump over the zombies. Maybe we should just do that. And not a whole lot of variety to the graphics, as I'm sure you've noticed. They kind of just made the one tile for all of the walls and ceilings and just used that over and over again. The background is just a still image. At least you can tell when you're in different general areas, the tile set does change, but... like there. Now we're just red blocks. Anyway, now that we have that jump upgrade, we can do this. So, we found an obstacle, this, before, then we went and got an upgrade, which now allows us to pass by this obstacle and continue on. You might almost call this a Metroidvania. What's this? Another jumping obstacle. We can't jump that high. No one could ever think about jumping that high, let alone the Ultimate Warrior. Obviously, we will never be able to get past that. Let's look at the computer. The Ultimate Warrior has trouble doing nothing. He just puts his mind to it, it gets done. Incidentally, when we read this dialogue, I do like to imagine that the captain is speaking in the voice of the Ultimate Warrior. I find that improves the quality of the dialogue. We keep going through these doors as that funeral march comes to its big climax, it seems. Anyway, new enemies. Since we have the shotgun, we can deal with a bit more now. That guy's very fast, and takes two shotgun blasts to kill. So things are getting more difficult. But as before, having to turn on generators does not change. We keep having to do that. Alright, and that should be all of them, since all of the lights came on. If we don't turn on all the generators in a room, there might be a door that has too low power to open. I think that one was one of those. It's completely different from a door being locked, you see. It's not locked, it's just that there's no power. I needed that, actually, because I'm getting very low on health now. I haven't saved, either. That could be a problem, because if I die, it would mean starting back at the beginning. So I probably should get around to saving when I can. An actual locked door. So there must be a computer terminal. Yep, there it is. It's a good thing the Ultimate Warrior is computer savvy. Or maybe he's not. Maybe he just uses his sheer force of will to order the computers to work. I think that's how he actually does it in real life. He just kind of yells at them, and they just kind of do what he says. Clyde reminiscing about times long past, before everyone on the space station was killed by monsters. Alright, Clyde says if we just keep going where we're going, we're going to find this communications tower, which is what we need to find, because we need that to contact Claire and get our ship back. Because it doesn't seem like we really need to do anything else, it was just a reconnaissance mission. It was just figure out what's going on. Oh, I can buy some life here. I'm going to buy some life, because I needed that. It was just a reconnaissance mission, find out what's going on and report back, and we seem to have... Found out that something's happening. Probably we have enough to make a report. So it doesn't seem like we really need to hang around here if we're able to get to that ship. I'm almost out of shotgun ammo, so if I could find a vending machine... Whoops, that's sold... That ammo. That was scary. I've lost pretty much all my... Okay, there it is. Gonna... Oh yeah, I have to switch the shotgun, then buy ammo. So I bought all that life. And... Can I reach that? All that life, and now it's just about gone. Okay, there we go. Increased my health a little bit. Of course, our credits are limited, so we can't just hang around here and just keep buying ammo. Even though we are getting some from these monsters. Up there. So maybe we can... from here... whoops. There we go. These monsters are just gonna pause while the warrior and Clyde have a little conversation about what's been happening. They're interested, too, in knowing what's happening. They're not getting any news themselves. They're just kind of stuck in this room. I'm sure they would like to know how this all happened. So everything was taken out initially by EMP, but that's gone now, so mechanical stuff should work like our ship. Even though anything that was here during the time of the outbreak is inoperable. Okay, that unlocked that door. Probably should have just bought some ammo while it was here, because I've already used some. Now, we're in the office of the factory. As you can tell, this looks very much like an office. Especially compared to the other rooms, you can really tell the difference. Whoops. Don't want to waste that. I mean, I know I keep bringing up that the tile sets are all very similar, but I mean, they did kind of use the same walls for everything. They kind of, like, didn't make any different patterns or anything to really separate one room from another. Like, everything just all does look the same. Oh, there's some bolts down there. Everything does really look the same. I'm not seeing any differences in this room from any other room. I'm sure it was a lot faster to put the game together like that. Just say, I want to make a room, okay, make it in this configuration, like everything that you can bump up against is this texture. And then everything that you can walk through is transparent, and we have this background, and there you go, boom, a room. And bang those out very quickly. We encountered a generator right away. Oh, that was the top of the room that we were already in. Since now we've gotten that final generator, there is another door, whoops, that we passed by. Just gonna top up, I think. Might as well just go down here, I think. We'll just buy some more ammo at the other machine. Alright, so there was another door in the room that should now be open because, whoops, we were able to turn on that generator. Lots of generator turning on, as I mentioned. That's the primary focus of the gameplay. Go in a room, it's dark, there are generators to turn on, so we better do that. Turn them all on, get the lights on, get the doors working, and that's pretty much every room. I'm actually going to use a save point right now, because there's actually a pretty good chance I'll die in the next room. Previously, they have not actually had any bottomless pits in the game. They're about to introduce that out of nowhere. Just have one last empty save file. Now let's ponder after dusk while the game takes a while to save. Let's ponder why this game might take so long. to save. Let's ponder the terror that you're obviously going through watching this. Because everything's so dark and there are monsters. Sound is so atmospheric. Okay, let's go through this door. Oh, really? Did I not hit all of the generators? Was there still another one? Just shoot these, get them out of the way. I missed one somewhere. It's not one up there. That one. Okay, that's the one I missed. Okay, now we can go through that door. So you see, if you don't get all the generators, it'll be just too low on power to open. Don't try to open it, you can't. We're in the pit. I don't know why this factory was built with a pit. I'm getting hit. But we get shot from both sides by this new enemy. Where is it? There it is. It's rather annoying. I haven't encountered an enemy that can shoot horizontally yet, just kind of enemies that can just drop stuff on us. And of course, if we mess up, we'll fall in that pit, which is instant death, so don't do it. There's a dilapidated wall over there. We can't shoot it. We have to kill all the enemies to get that to open up. And I'm almost dead. And I'm dead. See, like I said, good chance I was going to die in that room. We start from here with the logo, because of course... Honestly, I'm not sure why you would do that. Why would you not just have a load button appear on the game over screen that just instantly takes you to the room that you were just in, instead of actually having to go back to the title screen and load this all over again, especially considering how long it takes to load anything in After Dusk. Does take its time. After Dusk will not be rushed, not by you, not by anyone. All right, we still have to, let's see, hit that generator. Yeah, there it is. I am just going to pick up those credits again. I mean, use credits to buy health again, just to top up, because you saw me die right there. So that can happen easily in the pit. It's really the only room in the game that has any kind of challenge, I think. I didn't have any trouble with anywhere else, except that, where I died over and over again. Sometimes dying because of lack of health, and sometimes dying because I fell in the pit. Where is it? It's gotta come up, because I gotta kill it to advance. Can't advance if I don't get to kill it. Taunting me with that health. I can't get it because I'll fall in the pit and die. I'll die in my pursuit of health. I might do it this time. There we go. Okay. See, I destroyed it and this wall fell away, so that was the only way to get past it. Here's a computer. There's nothing on it. I think it unlocked this door. I assume so. Maybe the computer was just too frightened to talk back to Captain Ultimate Warrior. And there's a lot of stuff in here. So we might as well take advantage of it. Got an upgrade to walk faster. A new weapon, it's a machine gun. And another jump upgrade. I can think of a place where we could use a jump upgrade to jump a little higher. Maybe something that was blocking our path from advancing further. Something that we encountered before, maybe. Who knows? Might as well pick up these nuts and bolts, just in case we get enough to upgrade our suit again at one point. All right. Okay, now this is the terminal for communications. As you can tell, the communication tower looked very different from everywhere else we've been in. Well, I mean, the room was vertically oriented, so I guess in that way you could assume that it was a tower from which we would communicate. We've made contact with Claire. The Ultimate Warrior has hope springing in his face-painted face. Claire, however, is having trouble of her own. The Ultimate Warrior, however, does not intend to let Claire down. Oh, Miranda, we have someone new. Someone else who was surprised by our surviving. Miranda says it's not important who she is, but the Ultimate Warrior contradicts her. Methinks it might be. So Miranda having the same request as Clyde, she wants off this planet, because who wouldn't, right? Who wouldn't want to get off this planet? No, I haven't noticed any operation. I mean, there's monsters. That's the only thing we've noticed. Oh no, the military. Yeah, we didn't notice any military personnel on the planet. But apparently they're hunting Miranda. She can't tell us why. The Ultimate Warrior doesn't like dealing with people who are targeted by the intergalactic military. I mean, I guess we're working for the military, considering I guess they gave us this mission. That's who we're working for. Miranda trying to bribe the Ultimate Warrior? You can't bribe the Warrior. His principles are too strong. I mean, what his principles are could be in question. He feels very strongly about them. Miranda says she's good for it. Looks, I guess so. Looks legit. Why not? There's a lot of text in this part. But like I said, After Dusk does have more of a story than the other horrors we've been seeing so far. Ah, that's the communication tower. That's more obvious when you see it from outside. I guess we can't really question if we have a new apparent friend, since I guess we need all the friends we can get in this situation. But now we've done what we need to do with the communication tower. Now we have to continue going back to the surface and going east to try to get to Claire, who's having trouble. I think I'm just gonna save again because we have to jump over that pit again. And I have died doing that, so let's just save right here. Even though it takes a while. I like to know what it's doing. Like, why does it have to pause like that when it's going to save or load? Because you can't imagine there's a whole lot of information there that it has to process, right? Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe there's a whole lot going on behind the scenes in After Dusk. Maybe the Xbox's processor is just going into, you know, overtime, going to turbo, trying to process all of the AI and physics that are happening. You wouldn't notice it because the graphics are so simplistic, but I guess they're there. All right, so I have to jump, stand on this platform, jump over here. If I miss, I'll fall in that pit because I'll keep going to the right and miss that platform. It's happened before. But I made it this time. Okay, good. That was the thing I was worried about. Alright. So, once again, let's head back the way we came. Get back up to that surface. Actually, it doesn't take long to get back up to the surface in either case. It takes a lot longer to get down here than back up. Especially when we just run through everything. That does speed things up, honestly. I think we went around here. Yeah. I'm glad all these monsters have, are apparently doing pretty well for themselves. Carrying a lot of credits on them. How do you carry credits, by the way? Whoops. If they're credits, that kind of implies that it's not physical money. That it's just like a digital representation of money. So I wonder how you actually drop credits. Let's see, anything else? Hmm. Something down there. That's where we came from. Yeah, that was the door that we just came out of. Alright, so apparently this is the canyon east of our last position, where Claire is having trouble. So we should be reunited with her very soon. Let's try the machine gun. Oh, look at that. It's a human being. It's one of those military people that Miranda warned us about. Now that she told us about them, they've appeared. And they can shoot, they can fire, and they will try to kill us for some reason, even though we're working for them. We've now taken a human life. The ultimate warrior snuck up on that guy from behind and shot him with a machine gun until he was dead. We're just no better than a common murderer now. It's all gone wrong now. Our lives will never be the same. We were just killing monsters, having a good time doing that. So for some reason, we just straight up killed a human being. And why? Because Miranda told us there was some kind of purge operation going on? Why should we have trusted her to begin with? Just saw that military guy trying to shoot zombies and we killed him from behind. How could we do that? Seems low on power. Probably should find those generators and turn them on while we try to forget about the horrible actions that we have just taken. What a turn, what a twist After Dusk has made. The game has not addressed the morality of killing these military people, obviously because they want us to think about it ourselves instead of the game just flat out telling us. I'm sure that's why it hasn't made mention of it. After Dusk, it gets in your head. Makes you think. Once again, from behind. The ultimate warrior has no mercy for these men. I can't get those. I'd like to get those. After Dusk, also longer than the other XBLIG horrors we've played. Those games were done... Oh, the lights are killing them. Those games were done very quickly. We've been at this for, what, like 45 minutes around? So yeah, takes a while. Can I get that? Yeah, I got it. But, can I get up and... Oh, I could have just jumped up here. Nope. No, I could not. Okay. I don't think I can get up to there as of yet. I turned these generators on, and that one door was low on power, so we might as well go over there and look at it. Maze! That's promising. As far as I can tell, I don't really think there was anything else these credits were good for aside from the vending machines. At least I can't think of anything. So there's no real reason to save anything. Ugh, these blocks that are shifting in and out of reality for some reason. I don't know why. They don't hurt you or anything if they appear when you're in them. At least they have in my case. Didn't seem like they did. I don't need to go get that. Well, so far, nothing's been able to stop the Ultimate Warrior in his rampage, neither monsters or human beings. And it looks like we're getting even closer to Claire. Well, no, the communications are quite fine, it's just that this is how Claire is actually talking, you see. She likes to do that when we're pretending that there's problems with the communication equipment. It's kind of annoying. Because it's kind of a serious matter. She also kind of likes to make static noises with her mouth. She likes to go... She does that to cut off conversations with the Ultimate Warrior. You might sometimes do that in real life. You can understand why she might do that when she's talking to the Ultimate Warrior over the radio. And then, you know, it's like there's an asteroid belt in the way, so... You just have to do that once the warrior starts getting on one of his tangents. Oh, wait, this is the same room we were in. And we used a computer. So, okay, that door would have been previously locked. Oh, it's that thing again. You see, this is why, also why I think perhaps we weren't supposed to be able to kill it. Because it comes back here. And here. We can kill it. It's a lot tougher than it was the first time. Whoops. No. So you can see how many shots it's taking. Whoops. I can't leave here until I kill it, by the way. So that's why I thought that the first time I killed it, I probably was not supposed to be able to do that. Another upgrade. I can move faster, and I've gotten another weapon. This is another weapon that uses my my light energy like the first gun, but it is much more powerful than the first gun. I kind of like to use the ammo weapons instead of my energy weapons, because like I said, if I use my energy, I lose my light. And here's Clyde again. Clyde is not impressed with the Ultimate Warrior's performance. He thought we'd be ready to go. I don't see Clyde doing a whole lot to get this ready, I have to say. I don't think Clyde has any position to sigh at what the Ultimate Warrior has gone through to this point. See, Warrior, he's not taking any lip. He wants to know if Clyde can do anything. Can he be of any use? Can he do anything to get us out of here? Clyde knows the creatures very well. Let's not think about how he knows them on the inside. We're back to the funeral march music. I think Warrior has been doing pretty good for himself. I don't think we need to play this. I'm gonna go with weapon attack up. Because everything, you know, if we have refire up, great, it fires faster, but we use ammo faster. Hey, it's Claire. Oh, I think I activated the save point. Because, you see, Y is above both Claire. Yeah, there we go. Might as well do it while we're here. So again, what do you think about After Dusk so far? It's not scary in the same way that the other XBLIGs have been just nightmare-inducing with their stock photographs and Photoshop filters. I say that when there is an obvious Photoshop filter on the screen right now in the form of difference clouds, but it's actually not that bad of a game to play, honestly. It's more of a game than the others we've seen so far. Claire had doubts in The Ultimate Warrior. Who does she think he is? You should never doubt the Warrior's ability. Warrior doesn't know what to make of these people. Well, Miranda's being hunted by the military. Apparently they're trying to shoot her on sight. I don't know about all this harmless business. So we're missing the engine fuel cells from the ship, and the Warrior, well, he has to do something else before we can finally leave. Apparently the monsters took them for some reason. We could have left right now if we had those fuel cells. No, it is not. It keeps going on. All right. Let's see what's above us. Yep. stock up on ammo, see if we can upgrade our suit. No, we cannot, not enough bolts. And if you're wondering when the Ultimate Warrior said, how is she, meant this, that's the ship. And here's Miranda. So we're all in one place. Miranda continuing to attempt to bribe the Ultimate Warrior with junk that she found on the way here. She'll also offer us credits if junk's not good enough. I'm gonna take the junk because the junk are nuts and bolts, 5 of them, which gives us enough to increase our rig once again. Oh, I'm sorry, EV suit. Why would I think of calling it a rig? There we go. I do like the idea that it's just this vending machine that you pour nuts and bolts into, and then stuff happens to make your suit stronger. Anyway. Continuing on. So, Captain Ultimate Warrior, almost at the end of his adventure on Crux. If we can find these fuel cells, we can actually escape. Report back to the military on what's been happening on this planet and space station. As well as tell them that we've been harboring someone they're trying to kill, apparently, I guess. It seems like that's what we're doing. What's this? Experiments? About outbreaks? The Ultimate Warrior does not think too much about evil science. Apparently, this is just science run amok. These monsters, these zombies were created by the people on the station, the scientists? I can't believe it. Why would they ever do such a thing? I think I'm just going to try to just jump up here and just forget about everything. Yeah, skip everything. Whoop. Whoop. Nope, that's not working too well. Okay, there we go. Activated a generator. That's how this hallway works. We're just going to have to go in each of these doors, find a generator, and turn it on. Don't know what these generators are doing here. I mean, actually, I was about to say we look like we're in some sort of organic place, but what is this that we're in? I'm not sure what those tiles are supposed to be in the background, or multicolored hexagons that look like they're fabric stitched together. It's like we're in some kind of abstract universe. It is frightening. It is horrific, especially with this haunting piano music happening in the background. All right, let's continue on. This one's low on power, so we will need to activate more generators before we can get to it. I guess this piano music, this haunting, soulful music is here to make us reflect on the journey that we've experienced with the Ultimate Warrior up to this point. And the changes, the character development that we've had with these memorable developed characters, such as the Captain, such as Claire, Clyde, and Miranda. I doubt something called the Eternity Project would have anything to do with lab-created monsters and zombies. It's probably about flavors for candy. That's what these walls are. They've been infested with flavor. Oh, nanites? That's even worse. You're making monsters and then you introduce nanites into it? It's like they're doing all of the evil science things. Next, you're gonna get cloning into it, and then you're gonna... What other evil science things are there? Mind control, I guess. You're gonna just do all, like, put all that all together. Oh dear, we've heard the voice of the scientist before. Mm-hmm. So perhaps Clyde has been hiding something. Why is he really on this planet? I really don't like these enemies, so let's just jump past them again. Okay. More power generated on. And honestly, we've spent quite a bit of time with After Dusk, so let's just maybe run past these enemies. And of course, we do want to get back to Claire as fast as possible. If we suspect that Clyde perhaps is a no-good Nick. Gonna replenish my health right here. Alright, that one's locked. That other one was low on power, but we've turned on a generator since then, so it is open. But what might await the Ultimate Warrior and Claire as we approach the end of our journey? What possible climax could there be? Oh, Clyde, working on your immortality project. Who'd have thought it would have led to this? Yes, one thing at a time. First, we'll retrieve the fuel cells, get the ship working, and then we'll decide if we need to do anything with Clyde. I mean, if this is kind of all his fault, from what we're seeing... I guess I will have to kill that one after all. Alright, and that's the terminal that will unlock that last door in the hallway. Okay, no monsters are recorded on our sensors. Well, we haven't met any robots as of yet. Just that we know there's none of these bioorganic weapons, you might call them, in the upcoming area. Let's see, where was it? Just trying to remember, since they all look the same. Okay, there it is. Like I said, I understand why all of the tiles in these rooms are the same. Must have made it very fast, very easy to slap rooms together. But, I mean, maybe you could have tried to make some variety, maybe a little bit. Maybe more than one tile per room. Maybe make some object graphics so you could tell, you know, like it says we're in a library. Why would we think that, you know? I'm not sure why we would know we're in a library. Anyway, this place is crawling with those demons. But Claire said that there were no bio readings up ahead. Clyde. Clyde apparently had figured out that the jig was up. Clyde apparently really does know them inside and out. The Ultimate Warrior is pretty right on about this. I'm not sure what Clyde expects to do with these monsters. Clyde himself apparently is turning into a monster. But he's going to retain his intelligence, so basically he's Wesker. Oh, he's taken all of the nanites. Mm-hmm. Make us whole, Ultimate Warrior. I wouldn't say are women. I'm not sure if the Ultimate Warrior has any relationship with Claire going on. We just met Miranda. I don't even know who she is. Clyde going full supervillain, telling us to write a symphony with blood, and this is a long hallway with a lot of monsters in it, and we have to kill them all. The first time I played this, I ran all the way to the other end of the hall. It turned out that there was just nothing I could do down there. Alright, I'm gonna have to... Yep, let's do this. See, I get to the end of the hallway. Once I get to it. Eventually. Okay. Yeah, I can't shoot that, so it's a dead end. I have to go back and just kill everything. This is probably a better position to do it from anyway. Ran out of ammo, so let's get the shotgun. Now here's that other weapon I got. It's like I said, it's an energy weapon like my first one, but does a lot more damage. And if I get energy replenishment power-ups from these guys, then I'll be able to keep using it. That assumes I'll keep getting those replenishers like that. Because there are a lot of monsters in this hallway. This is the big final rush of monsters. Is that all? The sounds have stopped. And maybe, just maybe, the Ultimate Warrior, yes, has killed all of the monsters. They were no match for his battle cry, his fierceness, his guns, and his face paint. I like to imagine he's just wearing his face paint right now. Oh, here's Clyde. He's hanging around. He doesn't seem too alarmed that we reached him. All right, now he is. Well, it's just a kid. It's a joke. What? What? I mean, the whole ascension thing? You didn't think I was serious about that? The Ultimate Warrior is very into revenge and justice. It's all over. But what happened to the fuel cells? But Clyde's dead! How is he still talking? Clyde is pretty prepared, I have to say. If he has, with enough prep time, if he can survive a bullet to the head, then that's pretty impressive. And that's Batman level right there. We are kind of okay, never mind. So Clyde has shown himself to be a lot more formidable than perhaps the Ultimate Warrior had expected. Okay, we're back on the ship in the hold, but where is Clyde? Apparently, we could have left at any time, because the fuel cells apparently were here. They weren't where we thought they were going to be. Apparently, Clyde had them. So Clyde is going to give us a choice. In the left door is Claire, in the right door is Miranda. The Ultimate Warrior makes a good point. It doesn't seem like there's a reason at all to do that. Never mind. Clyde is not in the mood to answer any of the Ultimate Warrior's questions after getting shot in the head. Yep. Yo, he's gotta go. Gotta go. Anyway, let's take a look around. Activate that generator. So this is our ship. It looks like a ship. Let's replenish our ammo for the final confrontation. We can't upgrade that. Okay. So, there's a save point if we wanted, but last boss, honestly, is not too difficult. There are two doors, left and right. They said Claire was in the left, Miranda was in the right. We could save one, and the other one would die via nerve gas. Well, I mean, Claire is our partner and shipmate. We just met Miranda. I mean, maybe she's a good person, I don't know, but I mean, given the choice, I don't see how we could choose Miranda over Claire. I mean, we kind of have a responsibility to save Claire, right? So we'll go in and see what happens. Oh, there's Claire. She's trapped. But what is Oh, it's the horror. I've never seen such an abomination as what now waddles before us. Anyway, I'm not sure if this is supposed to be the final form of Clyde, or if this is just some other monster. I mean, Clyde was talking, so I might assume that this is him. This is his ascension, which I gotta say, that looks like something that's transcended mortality to me. That's the first thing that I think of when I look at that. And I haven't mentioned anything about if it's difficult. No, it's not. You can see how you beat it right here, which is just basically doing this over and over. It hurts a lot if you touch it. See? Yeah, there you go. Takes away almost half of my health. So we don't want to touch it again, but I mean, not like that's probably not gonna happen, right? It's just pretty much this. No health bar like with the slug dragon, but it is being hurt, even if you're not sure about it. I swear it's being hurt. There you go. It's dead, it's over. Here's Claire. Oh no. For all our efforts, and for all of Miranda's bribes, Miranda still died. Sure, I guess. Gasp! Evil pregnancy, the worst kind. So yeah, that's how After Dusk ends. Such a terrifying space future experience. A premiere Metroidvania, available, I believe, only on XBLIG. I don't think it came out on anything else. So that's After Dusk, our tale of zombies and monsters and evil science, as it always is, and evil pregnancy at the end, just throwing in that little curveball, that little twist. Oh, they're thanking me, the player. It's me. It says you, but they mean me. Well, let's say they mean us. The other ending, if we saved Miranda, the end? Even the game's not entirely sure if that's the end. It's asking us, not telling us, letting us come to our own conclusions. So the other ending, if we had gone with Miranda, basically the same thing. I mean, that final picture would have been different, but it does the same zoom in and the same glowing red eyes. So ends the same way either way. Kind of looks like there should probably be a third ending, right? And I could save it to start a new game plus, which if I wanted to. I don't know if there is a third true ending. I suspect maybe if there is, you can get it through new game plus. But I don't know how. I don't know if there is a way to do it. But maybe there is a way to get the happiest of endings and save both and make sure Clyde is actually permanently dead. Maybe there is. Maybe. Because it did say you had a question mark at the end of the end. Like I said, the unknown is the scariest, most horrific thing of all. And not knowing if After Dusk is over, not knowing if After Dusk, maybe I'll have to play After Dusk again. That's frightening. It's terrifying to not to know that maybe I'm not done with After Dusk. I'm terrified. We really were at this for a while, so this was a long video. I hope you've been able to get all the way through to the end with me and the Ultimate Warrior. With After Dusk. Available only on XBLIG. Like I said, it is much different from the other ones we've been looking at. So I guess it's up to you to decide if it was any better or worse than the other style of XBLIG horrors that we've been seeing. But this video's gone on long enough. That's After Dusk, yet another of the horrors of XBLIG. I'll see you next time.